tough political criticism on how the county was managed or mismanaged. Funds for road repairs may have backfired on Supervisor Allie Miller. According to the story from the Arizona Daily Star, the other four members of the Board of Supervisors voted Tuesday to gut funding for four road programs in her district and spend the money on emergency road repairs along Colossal Cave Road. The vote came after Miller initiated discussion of how the county spends its $5 million road maintenance budget and her proposal to redirect roughly $100 million in funding to other county programs. I only chuckle, Allie Miller, because if that's true, that is absolutely ridiculous. And the first thing that I thought of, Allie, was that it's childish if they actually did that in retribution because you asked some questions. That's unbelievable to me.
Yeah, I put an item on the agenda just with some suggestions for areas for Mr. Huckleberry to look. It is his job to determine where to find the money. I just put some suggestions, and one of them was this one fund on non-medical consultants that they had only spent $4 million out of, and they had budgeted $26 million. I thought, hey, there's a good place to look for some money, and I put a few other suggestions on there that he could look for possibly more money for road repairs this year. And as a result of that, I would call it nothing short of intimidation and intimidation tactics that were used against me and retaliation, because what they did at the end of the day, this was a separate item from our vote on the budgeting of our repair projects. We each got $1 million roughly in our districts to use for 2013-14, which is a drop in the bucket. It's about 3 miles of pavement, but we did get that money. And my projects were approved. I have a memo from Mr. Huckleberry dated November 14, 2013. We went through and we looked at some projects that were much more dangerous, where some elderly people on walkers were falling in their neighborhoods when they went out to try to walk. And that was one of the areas that we wanted to fix. And a section of Thornydale by the schools that is very, very dangerous that we wanted to fix. And those were all approved, and Mr. Huckleberry wrote this memo in November of 2013.
Okay.
And then they put this item on the agenda. Ray had a change to one of his projects, but other than that, there were no other changes. And suddenly, Sharon Bronson combines the two items, my item for the possible areas to find extra money to put into pavement preservation or road repairs, and combines them. And then at the end of the day, Richard Elias made a motion to remove the money from my district and put it into suddenly about 10 people show up from the Vail School District to speak. And one of my friends was in the audience, and one of the people that came from Vail said, "This is the first time I've ever been to a board meeting. I was called and told to come and speak about the dangerous conditions on Colossal Cave Road." And so they did, and then Richard Elias made a motion to move the money out of my district for repair projects into Ray Carroll's district, seconded by Ramon Valadez and voted by the majority of the board. What is interesting about this whole thing, the district with the most failed roads is District 1. We have 72% of failed roads in District 1. The rest of the districts have 62%. So to say there was more of an emergency for school children in District 4 is flat-out lie, because District 1, where one of the areas we were going to do is by Thornydale, by Mountain View High School, and down by the elementary school down there where people have to turn, it's very, very dangerous. And that road should have been widened, but they pushed that out to 2018 now. And so as a result of this, District 1 now has no more money to repair roads. And the taxpayers of District 1 pay a huge amount of taxes. We have asked the county assessor for this data, but now we are having to do a public records request because he will not give us this data. And we will find out what each district pays in terms of taxes, but the taxpayers of District 1 pay a huge amount of money. And the one thing, you know, as I've said before, many developers have called and talked to me about retaliation and punishment if they ask any questions or they dare to challenge the county. Well, now I have experienced it firsthand, the bullying, the cronyism, the punishing techniques that have been used against me for anything that I put on the agenda. Every week, they try to intimidate me with attacks. And there was a lady there yesterday who said, I've never seen anything like this. These people treat you horribly. They interrupt you. They're rude to you. And I said, oh, they're very well behaved today because there's a huge audience. They're typically much worse. And we have it all on video. Those videos will be going up today, but because the meeting ended at roughly 4:15 yesterday, we don't have them up. But we're going to put up the clip of Ray and Sharon laughing after the money was moved out of my district. This is a joke to them. This is not the proper way to manage a county. You act in the best interest of all the taxpayers above all else. But for this board, it is petty vindictiveness. It's not about the best interest of the taxpayers. And Chuck Huckleberry even put in the background material the constant contact that I sent out about the increasing taxes and the mismanagement of our HERF road repair money. And I stand by those words. There's no myth that our taxes are increasing. They are. And there is no myth about the mismanagement of road repairs. I mean, you don't need to spin that one or anything. If you drive on the roads in Pima County, you get it. You see it every day. You know your cars hit those potholes. So it was personal to him. And his face got very red as he was very angrily disputing that fact. It was not about finding a solution for our problems. It wasn't about, okay, let's take a look and go try to find some money. No, it was clearly a vindictive, and they're trying to intimidate me from putting anything else on the agenda. And the retaliation against the taxpayers of District 1 is beyond anything I have ever seen.
Have you talked to any of them since the meeting about any of this? Have you had any one-on-one discussions? I'd go to Ray Carroll and go, why were you laughing about this? Why is this funny?
No, they don't talk to me. And Ray Carroll, no, they don't talk to me down there. And if I went and discussed anything on the agenda, they would, I can't do that. It's illegal to discuss items on the agenda. It's a violation of open meeting law to discuss it before the meeting. So I want to avoid getting reporting for open meeting law violations. But what having these kinds of discussions with these people, I tried to talk to Ray Carroll early on, but it was clear that they had pitted him against me right from day one. The Democrats, and they have, he has been playing the game right along with them. They toss him some bones. They take the money out of my district and give it to his district. I'm going to talk to you about whether this is even legal or not, because this money was approved. And how can you disenfranchise a district? It just seems like there may be some legal issues here.
Well, it's not even just, I mean, look, it's one thing, obviously, it's one thing to have it be retaliatory against you, but it's a slap in the face to everybody in your district who, you know, by your own admission, it's only going to be able to improve a small stretch of roads, but that money was already approved. So, you know, if I'm, you know, able to vote for you, and I'm in that district and I find out that this happened, I mean, I'd be furious. Let's do this. Let me go to the phones. I want to make sure people have a chance to talk to you. 751-1041, and we bring on Ian. Good morning, Ian. Welcome to the John Justice Show, and you're on with Allie Miller.
Hey, good morning. Just a quick question about roads. Supervisor Miller, it seems as though a lot of attention has been focused on roads in your district, and I'm just kind of curious as to where you see more funding coming for new road improvements when a lot of it's been seemed to have the attention focused in your district.
Well, it's not just my district, it's the whole county. You drive anywhere in Pima County and the roads are falling apart,
There
is a significantly higher number, 72% of the roads in District 1 are in failed to poor condition. And I put together a list of areas that Mr. Huckleberry could look at. It is his job to determine whether or not the money can come out of those areas. But one of them was funding for non-medical consultants. It was an item when we did the budget review last year. We added up all the non-medical consultants in all the various departments, and that came up to $26 million. To date, only $4 million has been spent out of that fund. So I suggested that as a place. Maybe he could pull $10 to $15 million so that we could do some more road repairs. And the argument that a lot of money has gone into District 1. That's because District 1, number one, was neglected for years. And where did the growth occur? It was in District 1, Oro Valley, Marana.
Yeah.
This is where the town grew. So you obviously would be building the new roads where the town grew. Road impact fees were collected. Plus, you would do those new roads and road widenings in those areas where it grew. We still have many, many roads. For example, Thornydale, that has been on the list of our
projects for years. I was just thinking about that road just now, right before you said it. Yeah.
And that was one of the roads that we had
allocated
a little bit of repair money to just to get it through, because they've now pushed it out to 2018 for widening.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Thornydale and that split, is that Camino de Oeste? The split when you get north of Linda Vista.
Yeah.
And that curve off, because we take that quite a bit.
Way.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that is, that stretch of road. We all laugh. When we go down that road, Allie, my boys in the car, because usually we're heading down to El Molinito or Costco over there on the north side.
Do they go floor it, Dad?
No. They say turn the radio down and they go, because their voices do that. The road is so bad.
It is. It's
a running joke. All right, Allie, can you hang on the line?
Sure.
All right, hang on the line. We got some people that want to talk to you. 751-1041. Again, these funds were moved from Allie Miller's district after her criticism. It was the other four members of the Board of Supervisors voted to gut the funding for four road programs in her district and then move that money to emergency road repairs for Colossal Cave Road. And I have some questions in regards to the individuals who spoke at the meeting yesterday and who they were. And it's funny, Allie, from your district for roads, you know, even the Arizona Daily Star, it picked up. I mean, the headline, funds slashed for Supervisor Miller's district after criticism. I mean, it's as if that reporter saw what happened as well. Like, there was no hiding that this was retaliating against you for your criticism.
Oh, there was no hiding it at all. It was clearly well coordinated. The meeting went till 4 in the afternoon, and the folks who came up from Vail came up just about, I don't know, a half hour, an hour before they actually were to speak. I had people there early in the morning. They were showed up at 9 and they had to leave by noon after they had waited to speak. There were many items on the agenda, but these people from Vail School District showed up to speak.
Who were they?
Well, there were people from the Vail School District that were invited to come to speak. One lady told a friend of mine who was sitting in the audience, she said, "Oh, what are you here to speak for?" She goes, "Oh, we were called and asked to come speak about the Colossal Cave Road, which is the emergency repair they need to do with the money that they took from my district." It was clearly coordinated, Ray Carroll couldn't make the motion because it was in his district.
Right.
So Richard Elias made the motion. Ramon seconded it. And it was clearly intimidation.
Let me, I'm gonna stop you there because I want to make sure we get these phone calls. Okay. Let's go and talk with Doug. Good morning, Doug. Welcome to 104.1 The Truth, and you're on with Allie Miller.
Good morning, John, Supervisor Miller.
Good morning.
I live in Continental Ranch, but I am familiar with Colossal Cave Road. It's out past the Rancho Del Lago, if people aren't familiar with where it is. And, obviously I don't have any statistics, but I would fully believe if you look at usage and traffic, that Thornydale has at least three times the usage each day as Colossal Cave Road. How in the world can this not come up and they just ignore it?
Yeah, how do they justify that the Colossal Cave Road was more important than where you had the money allocated in the first place?
They had the 10 speakers get up and speak about how dangerous it was for the children, and then Richard Elias made the motion. There was no discussion whatsoever. They just made this motion. I've spoken about Thornydale, how dangerous it was, and the children. I talked about how we have children on that road and how dangerous it is for the school buses with the children. I've nearly had a head-on collision there myself, getting caught in those ruts on Thornydale Road.
Yeah.
And I agree, it does have far more traffic. This was purely a retaliation for me putting out the information for the public to see, for putting out the videos, and Chuck had my constant contact in the background material of the item on the agenda.
Let me grab John here just so we don't we make sure we get the calls in. Good morning, John. Welcome to 104.1 The Truth, and you're on with Supervisor Allie Miller.
Hi, John. Hi, Supervisor Miller.
Mike.
I am a resident of District 1. I have been actually for a long, long time. I'm pretty disturbed about this myself because, and you kind of touched on it, but to go a little deeper into this, it seems to me like this is a violation of intergovernmental agreements. It's certainly a violation of RTA because, not too long ago we had an RTA bond, to widen that there on Thornydale. But, beyond that, we've actually voted, it's either four now or five times to have that widened. It's been approved by the voters. The county refuses to do it. It initially started off a thing with, the birds, which has now become a non-issue.
We're almost out of time, John, so get to your point so Al, they can respond.
Well, I think it's time that Allie, maybe you should take this out of the county, take it to Maricopa County, and sue the county, and also take it to the state attorney general's office and have the state fully investigate, what the heck is going on down
Allie,
there.
Allie, I have a minute left. What are you going to do from here?
I will be speaking to the attorney general's office, and he is...
Sorry, that's okay. Go ahead.
He is correct that the RTA, that this has been on the RTA list for years, and it should have been done long ago. But now, yesterday, they approved moving the Hughes Access Road, which is going to cost the tune of $14 million by the time they're done, moving it half mile south to accommodate an industrial development.
With 30 seconds left, is there anything that people can do to help you right now?
Please contact my office, 724-2738. We are going to ask everyone to start contacting the Attorney General's office about this issue. We need to do something about this.
Okay. Allie, we're out of time.
I
thank you so much for the time this morning.
Okay, thank you.